Shiam Nanan, Qwo-Li Dawado, and Hialieni Nega, Animomia, Him Elo, Hialieni Animoni Ayed. Hi everyone, I'm Qwo-Li, and I want to thank the Ohlone Nation whose land we're on, and also to acknowledge all of the indigenous people who survived La Mission de San Francisco at sea. Let me try to move around here with my skirt and shoes and cane. Shoot. Alright. Okay, the cane has to go on the floor. Alright. Oh. Unenrolled. Let's face it, Mama. No one wants us. What kind of Indians are we anyway, all kinky-haired and blue-eyed, red and blonde and brown and black hair? Governments don't care about stories. They care about allotments, documents, census numbers. Listen to our muddled tongues and you will hear the dust of southeastern Colorado clinging against the hoofbeat of night riders burning crosses in front of Quaker houses. And before that, the mines of southwestern Missouri, farms in Kansas and Indian Territory. And before that, homes in Tennessee and North Carolina and Georgia. Look at our mixed blood faces, and you see the granddaughter of a French colonist slave owner marrying a black Indian indentured servant trying to live free in the North Carolina swamps. And before that, there was Mi'kmaq, and even there, we came from somewhere far north, somewhere far south, made a people. It's been a while since we stayed anywhere long. Genocide does that. Slavery does that. Land theft and Jim Crow and Indian territory and allotments do that. At night, I dream the Mali Empire, Muslims from West Asia mixing with Yorubas and Mandinkas. I dream a song from a madrash filling southern Europe. I dream migrations from India and Ethiopia. I dream Pictish. I dream Cherokee. I dream all of us home. Let them have their nation. We'll build our own like we've always done, out of whatever we can carry on our backs. Dawes Commission, found poem. Alma L. Bell and Eddie C. Shoemake versus Cherokee Nation, Office Commission on Citizenship, September 12, 1889. Dennis B. Bushyhead, who after being duly sworn, states as follows. I am 63 years of age, live at Tahlequah Cherokee Nation. I don't know of any Cherokees by the name of Shoemake. When I lived in California, there was a family of Shoemakes and Oxendines that lived in one neighborhood who claimed to be Cherokees. That was in Calaveras County. They came from that country from Sebastian County, Arkansas, and looked like darkies to me. Some of them were nappy-headed. There must be songs for this. Uwodige, uwodu. I breathe the words out, round as smoke. There must be songs for this. A formula to bring back stolen children. Songs for protection. Medicine for return. There must be a ceremony we created after the boarding schools and removals and wars. Sassafras spit to beg thunder. A pinch of tobacco in the first light of morning. Miss Veronica, I don't know you. I'm just another broken heart, a blue witness sending prayers on smoke to the east, and the war isn't over. You are returning to land close to our mother mounds. They will sing lullabies. Ka! There are old songs belting from the strong lungs of men who love you. There are old rhythms shaking from the strong legs of women who love you. There are old prayers rising as smoke from people who love you. There are old words sprouting from the hills that love you. Ka! Dugalutsi, 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 dugalutsi. She will come back, 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 she will come back. After the shootings, Prompenbog, December 14th, 2012. The names of children, sharp needles of loss we use to suture the gash of memory that rises from Potatuck land. The story bleeds onto us, shouts rapid fire, crumbles behind desks, a story with a trigger and not enough time to hide, a story we didn't want to hear but can recite by heart. America. For Angie Zapata, in this version of the story, you live. There is no fire extinguisher against skull, no moment of terror before your last breath howls through broken ribs. In this version of the story, you live. We all live. Praise song to stone for my father. Praise sternum cracked like mica after the truck's impact. Praise teeth and lower jaw sheared clean as marble rushing down his throat. Praise ghosts watching from behind granite graves across the street at the Rosebud Cemetery. Praise body arched like sandstone illuminated by headlights as it flashes through air before landing on the other side. Praise dust that surges as he hits earth, scatters like crows and disappears quick as the car's driver into the pre-dawn dark. Praise the crack of vertebrae as it slips like a fault line, the schism of spine that cleaves like feldspar, flecks of shale that glint like witness embedded in his side. Praise the cleavage of ribs, jagged as a saw as they pierce through lung tissue. Praise the lungs. Praise the ghost who leans over his body, gentle as breeze through muslin curtain, shouts through gurgle of jugular, go away. This graveyard is full. Praise the dead. Praise blood slow as lava beating from skull onto the road's shoulder. Praise gravel warm and full as a mosquito. Praise the blood. Praise the quartz crystal and the man's cell phone who stopped his car, dialed 911, covered my father with a blanket. Praise the diamond the size of a tear on the wedding band of the doctor who declared he might live even after the machines confessed there was no brain activity. Praise mercy. Praise the heart of red jasper that stopped beating and beat again, that stopped beating and beat again inside the helicopter as it buzzed over the valley. Praise diamond edge of scalpel as it slices skin like silk to fit bone back inside right arm. Praise the bone, praise the arm, praise the ghosts of children who played hopscotch on the beige tiles of intensive care, who laughed because of impossibility, and praise the living, praise the living, praise the living. This marvel of bone, revelation of marrow, awe of skin that knits itself back together. Praise this miracle of the quick and the dead. Crossing over, his tissue paper skin, wicked witch green, afraid will tear or break to